Quake in the originally in the Quake days, live on three was you do a you always know that it's the start of the game because they do a triple reset. So you go reset, 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 and then you're done.
All right, so this game is off 1 of 4. Aatrox is on Marines. Team 156 is on Aliens. We see Aatrox started in Atrium and 156 starting in Subaccess.
Indeed.
Havoc and Destruct coming in through glass hallway. Took a couple pot shots at one of Team 156 Skulks, but we got Scaredy Bob and Underline. That's what I'm going to call him. Coming in for a kill, and he just gets owned. Scaredy Bob did not follow him in that attack.
Meanwhile, over on the other side of the map, though, flight control pretty much uncontested by the by 156, so Aatrox is able to get in there and pretty much take complete control, no competition. Everyone seems to be focusing on Crossroads right now as 156 Scotty and Lurkinoff come in to fight Havoc and Destruct, but they both get taken out. Meanwhile, up in Crevice, though, Red Hook is trying to take down that RT, but he gets intercepted by Hal and Marshall.
Yep, leaving that RT at 34%. We're seeing these two Marines, Havoc and Destruct, coming into Computer Lab. We got Underscore right behind him, taking down Destruct. And now it's Underscore versus Havoc. He was on low health. Anyways, he goes down. 43% on that RT, only 50% grown. These guys got to get in there to stop Havoc so they do not lose that res. And they do end up pushing him out.
Yeah, and 156 has been trying to do some res harassment here as we see Aatrox's Hal and Marshall just snipe out two down that hallway into Computer Lab. That leaves Scotty with very low health as the only one. He's definitely going to go down. 7% left and two people there. There's no question that that's going to get taken out. We did see several of the 156 players harassing res nodes in Crevice and Reactor Core, but not able to finish. Those res nodes remain at 39% and 34% respectively. So maybe they'll get someone in there to finish off, but down in sub-access, Marshall and Hal have pushed through Computer Lab and are down in sub-access, starting to hit on those Hydras that have been set up. Scotty's the only one there right now. We do see that Devox is coming in to assist as well. Red Hook is following behind as it's lurking off. Red Hook almost gets taken out. They're going to go through that vent, try and get a drop on Devox. Red Hook is going to be able to take out Devox. Here they come onto Marshall and Hal.
Wow.
They are quickly dealt with. And they kill Scotty as he spawns as well. So we now have all but Scaredy Bob and Playa 2B are dead. Scaredy Bob gets taken out. Playa 2B is the only one in the hive at sub-axis. There are two eggs total. If they can get those eggs down, this is going to be GG. Red Hook spawns as those lurking off. They have to handle this right now. And you know that Aatrox is going to be sending their entire team to handle this. Although looking at the mini-map, I see no one heading down to reinforce. There's a beacon.
What?
Oh,
what just happened there? I cannot even see on this map what would warrant a beacon. That they had it. All they needed to do was send people down to reinforce.
What?
Wow, that if that was on purpose, my question is why? And if that wasn't on purpose, then that was definitely a mistake, and that's a big oops.
Yeah, that was GG. Like, without question, right there, GG.
Wow. Wow.
Everyone
was dead. That Ritual either did that on purpose or pulled him back on accident. We see now Havoc and Destruct in Data Core going against Scaredy Bob and Underscore. Destruct goes down. Havoc's the only one left. He goes down. Three Marines now coming back into sub-access, restarting their push that they had before that they were rudely interrupted by their commander. Red Hook trying to stop this Marine offensive and getting pounded in the process. 17%. He's just trying to climb the ceilings and get away. He gets taken out. There are three eggs left in sub-access.
But here comes Lurkinoff from down the corridor Computer Lab. He's going to sneak up behind. He's got the jump on him. He's going to get Marshall. Marshall goes down, but Vox is there. Lurkinoff definitely hurt. He's going to have to finish this off right now. Scaredy Bob comes in to assist as a player B, player to B, and that's going to be the end of that push. I mean, oh,
Man. Wow, and Destruct and Havoc in Data Core, 50% on that resource, on the alien resource tower. I don't even know what to say with that push. I'm still, my mind is still on that beacon.
I know. I'm sitting here. I mean, I have seen, like, if the only thing I can think of as to why that would have been an intentional beacon, is if they were down there calling for reinforcements and their commander was saying no. And they were saying, no, you don't understand. There's two eggs left. They've just spawned. That's it. That's all there is. And the commander said no and beaconed them to get them out of there.
Yeah. Well, after they beaconed, I honestly was looking around the map seeing, okay, was there a threat that needed to be countered, you know, real quickly or whatever? I mean, usually you also see, like, a beacon
Everyone
just
was
to get
dead.
New... Yeah, you usually see a beacon to get new tech real fast, you know? We usually see the beacon to get jetpacks real quick, but usually they can get back to where they were quickly because of phase gates, or it was, you know, a beacon jetpack.
Right, and that's not the case.
Well, you know, in Data Core, Marshall, Destruct, and Havoc now putting up the power in Data Core. They know that the aliens are trying to assist into there to try to take that as a base. Lurking off just on the ceiling, Scaredy Bob as well. He gets taken out, and Scaredy Bob and Underscore in there. They get pushed away, but Havoc gets taken out. So one Marine down there, and we're seeing an attack in Atrium from Scotty. They're attacking the observatory, 34%. He gets taken away by a infantry respawn. Devox and Hal in computer lab fixing the power. That could possibly be a spot for a phase gate. They do have that research, and they could drop a phase gate in computer lab and just hammer sub-access because they're closing off Data Core from the aliens.
Yeah, they're closing off Data Core, yep. And flood control is already well under their control. They're going to keep pushing down. They're putting up a phase gate in computer lab right now. That power is at 99%, so that's going to get finished very, very soon here. We do see a ping going on, so they're going to know that there's nobody there to attack them. Scotty is coming through the fence, but he's going to be too late to stop that. The phase gate is complete. There's an armory going down as well.
Oh, boy.
And there's three in Data Core. So while that was I guess misclicked recall beacon, it doesn't seem to matter because it created such a resource gap and a positioning gap that they seem to have no trouble getting set up here to shut down any kind of advancement from Team 51 or Team 156.
Yeah, and guys, let's look at the map here real quick. Basically, they own the Marines own all this, right? Anything above this line that I'm drawing, the Marines have control of. It's very hard for the aliens to get out of ventilation and sub-access. They're doing just a great job.
Yeah, you know, my question is, are they going to send some people to sitting on only three res nodes right now, and that is not enough. You have to have four to compete with the aliens, who are still sitting on three. They do have crossroads. I think they believed that it had been desisted and it was going to die, but they went ahead and assisted through pipeline. Cut that assist chain down right now. That's going to be a-okay on the res flow for Team 156, and they could be able to get back into this, especially because, like I said, Marines are only sitting on three, and that's not.
Yeah, and that big push here in the main base in sub-access. I mean, there are three Marines in there, fourth one coming up. They are just taking out the eggs like crazy. This is tough. Carapace just went down. This is it.
We are down to zero eggs. Play a 2B.
GG.
Beacon! Hey, where's the beacon?
Yeah, where's the beacon? Beacon them out. Oh, Aatrox playing a solid game. I mean, their strategy right from the beginning was to lock Team 156 into sub-axis, and they pulled that off beautifully.
Yeah, definitely very well done.
Even with the mistake of the beacon.
They did just drop a hive in Crossroads, but they did send Destruct there to handle that. So this is not going to be an issue. I mean, really, honestly, the best thing that could happen right now is if Playa 2B pops out, or Scaredy Bob, who was just able to spawn, if he runs up to Crossroads in order to kill Rush, they might be able to get that hive done. It is at 38%, but I'm pretty sure this one's over at this juncture.
Yeah.
Security Bob is the only one alive. Sub access has been cleared out. Yeah.
This is just, I mean, they could just call GG right now and save some time. But I think they're going to stick it out till the end.
Man.
20% on this hive. Havoc coming in to help them out. And this is it. Scaredy Bob, come on, buddy! Oh, Aatrox wins.